the end of Stop and Frisk happened at a time when crime was really being kicked out of town. There was very little crime going on in the city. Do you have any concerns that as violent crime increases to this extent, that the political support for curtailing Stop and Frisk will erode and that more people will become sort of impatient with this and maybe leap to seeing Stop and Frisk as a tactic that should be used more and more on the streets?
It's a good question, Henry, but I think the systematic, I think overtly racist use of Stop and Frisk was an abject failure, and it's been proven now for years and years. That is not a strategy you're going to go back to under any circumstance. And I think the people of the city feel very, very strongly that it was a mistake. And I think it put our officers in a horrible situation as well, in a very unproductive situation on top of being one that was, in effect, discriminatory. So, no, I don't see us going back there. I also have to remind you, when we made the decision to move, you know, deeply away from Stop and Frisk, no, crime was still noticeably higher than where we are now. Remember that we came in with still a lot of crime challenges to deal with. And, in fact, it was that we could fight back crime consistently over years, reduce crime without Stop and Frisk. That was one of the things that really proved to people why it was the wrong strategy all along. So I think that memory will be clear, and I don't think we're ever going back to that.